Also, the gnathosoma of pedipalps and chelicerae consists of nothing else than modified limbs. The whole gnathosoma apparatus is lifted up when the mite tries to feed from a wall-like substrate structure. It is moved down in order to feed from the underground. When turned to the right or the left, sensors seek for a suitable food source. It's a multifunctional organ with membranous structures along the distal part of the mouthparts. They are able to create an underpressure to easier incorporate food particles. They can also be pressed against a wall to enable the chelicerae to bore inside to catch suitable food particles. The morphology of the very complex filter-feeding mouthparts differ the family Histostomatidae from all other mite groups. The chelicerae in these mites are stiletto-shaped and not scissor-like as in other mite groups. Their slender morphology makes them highly flexible to reach food on, for example, an uneven underground. Mites of the Histostomatidae feed on microorganisms, precisely on bacteria and fungi. The following footage shows the excretion via anospore. I don't know whether the visible droplet is a gland secretion or indeed liquid with digested food particles. The whole footage of this video is presented in slow motion.